Hey guys, welcome to another exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess, and today's video we'll design this unique letter D. And if you look at this closely, this small portion is made from using the ellipse tool, and after that one of the anchor points has been modified to form an angle of 90 degree angle here, and then duplicated one more times to make the bigger one. And we have added two line segments of equal length, and we have deleted this subtracted from the main body, and later we have added the gradient color. So let's begin with the tutorial. To start with the tutorial, we'll select the ellipse tool, remove the fill color and fill the stroke color, make the stroke thickness to 12 points, and now left click your mouse button and let's give some now points here. The values you can put your ways. I'm putting 35 points and click OK. So this is the size which I want here. Now the next thing is we need to make one of the anchor point and one of the side to be 90 degree angles. So to do that, we'll use the ruler tool, Control R, to bring out the ruler. Now just click and drag it out and place it there. In the same way, again select it from the top, click and drag it out and place it there. So we got the dimensions. Now we will select the object, this, and in the pen tool, add anchor point, we'll add one anchor point here and we will modify this point. So just select with the die selection tool and place it there, and after that, using the convert anchor point tool, we'll just click over there and it will automatically make it to 90 degree angle. Now you can remove the delete the rulers and Control R to unhide the rulers grid again. And after that, we got the basic shape here. Now next thing is to duplicate this. Control C, Control F to paste it in the front, and in a transform we go and we'll just scale this width and height to around 85, and this, and you can see it's grown. Now we will maintain the thickness, so let's keep it 12. Now so the next thing is we'll make two line segments, one over here and another here. So we'll use the line segment, and from here with the shift selected, just drag it up and that's all. Now in the same way, we'll draw one more, shift selected and drag it up, and this much. So got it. Now select everything, go to object, expand, and this will convert all these strokes into object form. You can see that. Now we need to delete this portion. To delete that, we will draw out a rectangle tool. Using the rectangle tool, we'll just draw a rectangle here, this much big, around this much, and we'll just subtract it there. So select this, and in the pathfinder subtract. And now select both the rectangles, arrange, bring to front. Now we have got the basic shapes. Now the next thing is to apply the gradient color perfectly. So to do that, I have prepared two gradient color here. You can see one is for our two line segments, and another is for these two species where we need some dark color here to show the depth. So this is the one. So we'll select this with the art picker, select the color. Now with the gradient, we'll just adjust few things, but before that, select both of this and again fill the gradient color, and let's do some adjustment like this, around like this. Okay, and after that we'll do for this also, and using the gradient tool, just give it depth. In the same way, select the other one, using the gradient tool, give it a depth. And just let's check it out. And here you can see some lines are there, so you have to play with the gradient color. So let's select both of them. And let's apply the gradient color properly. See, Okay, now it's merged. So we got our logo. We have applied the gradient color and we have given some depth here also. So last thing is we'll be adding the text. To add the text, we'll use the text tool. Type out DIRECT. We are using the SF Old Republic bold here for this logo, and we'll change the color to gray. So just click and just give it some lighter gray. And after that, we'll select one of the text like this letter D and fill it with some different color like the dark blue or blue, and place it in a respective place. So this is how we have created this logo. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.